I received a few comments recently on my Windows Secure Erase and Reset video, and they're claiming that they can use simple, free data recovery utilities to restore the data that's been secure erased. I have my doubts, because once that data is overwritten, it should not be recoverable by a simple utility. So, in order to test that, I'm currently on a machine. It's a used Dell desktop computer. It has a 500 gig hard drive, a mechanical drive, and it is loaded up. I put copies of all kinds of video files that I have. I have data backups. There's thousands of PDFs and spreadsheets that are personal and things I wouldn't want to get out in that folder. And then on the root directory, here's another copy of it. And just to show you how large these are, this right here has 7,600 files, 3.19 gigs of copies of receipts and spreadsheets, and you name it, it's in there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually perform the Windows Secure Erase, Windows Reset, and then we're going to log onto the fresh, cleanly erased computer and run a few of those data recovery utilities that were mentioned to see if anything really does remain on the drive. We'll see if they can find any files whatsoever that are data, personal, spreadsheets, just anything. And then also I'll use a Windows Hex Editor to pull up the drive and look at the bits and bytes and hexadecimal codes just to see what does it put on the drive. Does it fill it up with a bunch of zeros? Does it fill it with a bunch of random characters? So let's get to it. I'll run the Windows Reset right now, and I'll fast forward through this to try to get you through quick. Here's where we want to do the clean data yes. That means it will overwrite all unused portions of the drive multiple times to get rid of the data and clear out that space. So this is the part they're having doubts that Windows Reset actually resets and wipes and clears it. I think it will. They say no, let's find out. So I'll just use simple settings here, making sure clean data yes is on. We'll click confirm, next, and away the process goes. So I'll see you on the other side. All right, the Windows Reset and Secure Erase process finished, and we're back at the Windows desktop. When the camera was off, I did install my screen capture program, a copy of Recuva, which is a data recovery program, and also HXD, which is a hex editor that lets you look at every little piece and part of the hard drive. So now what we want to know is, are there any traces of any files, data, videos, documents, PDFs, anything left from the previous installation? Now, this drive was jam-packed with data. It was about 400 gigabytes of stuff that I added to it. So even the fact that I loaded my screen capture, loaded Recuva, and loaded this little HXD utility wouldn't make a difference. It would have overwritten such a small part. There's still a ginormous amount of data that's left to be recovered. So let's go ahead and try it out. So I'm going to open up Recuva on the recommendation of some of my viewers. And so here we've got the wizard. We'll do next. We'll say show all files. And let's say search everywhere on this computer. I'm not sure which files. That's fine. And for now, we're not going to do the deep scan. So this is a real quick just view to see if it can find at a glance a few files it can recover. So I'll hit start and we'll zip through this and see what it finds. Okay, here we go. So I'm not worried about this hard disk volume it couldn't mount. It was probably some partition used by Windows that does not have any data anyway on it. So in the list, there are quite a few listed. I see it says that there are 8,527 files found. Now that doesn't necessarily mean that those are files from before the Windows Secure Erase procedure. So let's dig through them and see what we can find. So I'll just zip down. It looks like it has path here. Let's sort by path. And then I'll just pull down the slider. So, you know, $extend, that's nothing that is user data. We'll keep going down here. All right, let's go a page at a time. Root directory. So far I don't see user data files. I just see pieces and parts of Windows that might have been deleted during the Windows reinstallation. So as I keep clicking through here, I don't see any Word, Excel, PowerPoint, PDF, video files. I'm still in the Windows WinSXS folder. Let's go down past that. And I haven't seen any user data files yet. Let's keep going. And that's it. So if I zip up and down this list, it didn't find any of my PDFs, Word docs, Excel spreadsheets, videos, anything from before, from what I can tell right now. So there was an option for a deep scan. So let's go ahead and use the Recuva deep scan to see if that produces better results. Now that takes hours, so I'm gonna keep cutting in and out of this video and I'll show you the results at the end. Let's close Recuva completely, rerun it, and answer the startup question. So we'll do all files again, and I'll click next. Search everywhere on this computer, that's fine. And then enable deep scan, we'll check the box. Now this is where it literally will look at every piece of the drive to search for anything it thinks could be a file that we could recover, and it'll show us what that might be. So here we go. All right, it looks like Recuva just finished the deep scan, and let's see here, we'll ignore this error. Okay, let's scroll through the files and see if anything data related was found. So we'll sort by path. These first files are system files, things that are definitely not our user data. Let's scroll down a little more. Okay, even the directory name, /$extend, let's keep going. Okay, here we go. Okay, here's the root directory. So far, nothing data related is coming up. I don't see any PDFs, docs, XLS, JPEG, anything similar to that. And remember, this drive was packed full with 400 plus gigabytes of my data files, so there definitely should be tons and tons and tons of them if there was anything to find. Okay, here's that WinSXS folder. And that's it. So the Recuva deep scan did not find any files whatsoever, even though there were over 400 gigabytes of files. So I think I'm calling this myth busted, at least with Recuva. So I'll try one more data recovery program just to see if maybe this one just doesn't do a good job of it. And we'll see what happens there. I've installed a program called Disk Drill, which is real popular in the Mac world, and they also have a version that works on Windows. And this is the paid pro version. This is actually $80.10 right now today on the website. And let's see if that has any better luck deep scanning and locating files. So we'll go ahead and open up Disk Drill and see what happens. So it's recognized my hard disk drive. It's a Seagate 500 gigabyte. And we'll go ahead, instead of just clicking the drive and telling it to search, we'll actually right click that drive and do the deep scan, which really thoroughly goes through the whole hard drive, every sector, every cluster from the first one to the last one. And it tries to search to see if there are any files that it can identify that are still on the drive, whether they're marked as deleted or not. I had put about 400 gigs of my personal data on the computer, so it should not find anything because we did tell Windows Reset to do the secure erase. So let's see what happens. I'll click on Deep Scan, and that process will take hours. I'll fast forward again. Now you will see that it will find pictures and videos and files, but those are from after the secure erase where Windows repairs and updates itself and prepares the fresh installation. The ones I'm interested in would be any pictures, documents, PDFs, video files, Word, Excel, Outlook data files, any of that kind of stuff that was on there from before the secure erase. My suspicion is we're not going to find anything, but let's see what happens. Disk Drill just finished its scan, so you're probably saying, wow, look at that, 54,000 documents, 29,000 pictures, 157 videos. Well, it depends on what those things are. They might actually be files that were part of the Windows reinstall on the fresh copy that the Windows Reset loaded. But if they're not, and they're old data files, we want to know that. So I'm in here just with you guys. I'm not sure what it found. Let's find out. So with this program, I can click on any of these categories. Like here, we'll click on pictures, and let's just take a look at what it has. So it has a folder called deleted or lost. And that number is the same, so that's probably the same thing. Reconstructed. So let's open up this right here, the 19,682. And now it's showing which folder it found those in. So anything in program files isn't going to be my own personal data. My stuff's more either off the root folder or it's in the C:users JSON or C:users user folder. So program files, it looks like that's nothing to worry about. The program files x86, same thing. None of my data would be in those folders. Here's the users folder. Now there might be traces of things that I've done since I started using the computer to make this video, such as loading the OBS, loading the scan programs and whatnot. So let's see here. So it did pick up my current real user folder, and that's right here. Let's expand that. Okay, and the only thing under there is app data. So let's see what it found in there. Local, Microsoft. Okay, again, we're already somewhere that I don't store files. And then these are just images and logos and parts of Windows that it loaded after the Windows reset procedure started making everything fresh again. And yeah, here's a folder called Windows. So none of my data is under there. Reconstructed 9,989. Let's open that up. And it has a bunch of pictures. Let's see if there are anything that would be from before. So it doesn't appear so. ANI, BMP, or bitmaps. I've never created those myself. So GIF and JPG. Okay, these are all just random Windows and program pieces. So here's JPEG. That would be some generic Adobe Fireworks files. I still don't see anything that's my personal data. And as I scroll down, looks like we have a long way to go. Let's see if it lets you double click on one of them, like this right here. I'll double click. Okay, so we have a preview on the right side. And as you can tell, these are just generic like that. People have seen these inside of Windows. You know, the default screensavers and everything. Let's keep going down the list here. Okay, so it did find quite a bit, but nothing that was from my previous configuration before the secure erase. All right, let's try something different. Let's look at videos. Now, there are a few from my OBS program right here used to make this video, but let's see what it found. MP4 are the ones I always make for my videos, so let's see what that turns up. And let's see here, user videos, one. Now, so that's actually part of a video file that I created after the drive was secure erased that I'm using to make this video right here, so that's not bad. Reconstructed, let's see what those are. MP4, Handbrake. Yeah, so these are not anything that was from the previous installation. Under audio, I did have a lot of MP3s, possibly WAVs and other files. Let's take a look here. All right, those two directories right off. Nope, not me. Let's look at WAVs. Okay, I don't see any of my directories there. Under audio, WAVE, nothing. Now I'm curious in this documents folder, 54,000 things. Let's see what in the world those are. So deleted or lost, and so far these are all programs and system folders. Here's a public desktop. No, again, things that I made this video with, that's not important. Under users, normally the places in here would be documents, desktop, videos, pictures. So underneath there, I have app data, and I do not see Outlook underneath there. We can minimize app data and see what else is in there. Okay, desktop 3, these are gonna be the shortcuts that I've made making the video. Links. So no data there. Well, good news, I'm not finding any data. Even though it shows a whole bunch of stuff is recoverable, a lot of them are live files that are on the drive right now and or things that were deleted after the secure erase. So last thing would be this other folder, DLLs, manifests, MUI, none of those are mine either. So even a paid program like Disk Drill was unable to recover any of the files that were on the system before the Windows secure erase was done during the Windows reset process. So as long as you told the Windows reset to erase everything and selected the clean data yes option, you'll have peace of mind knowing that that data has been overwritten and will not be recoverable, even using a paid program. That makes perfect sense to me because of the way that the secure erase erases every portion of the hard drive and puts new information at each spot. How could it go back in time and know what was in a particular place before the current information was written there? I think only the FBI, CIA, and high-up government agencies and very advanced data centers would have a method of going back to previous generations of data to know what was there before the current item is in its place. So people using these common data recovery tools, they'll be able to get what's there now, but not really beyond to the older generations of the data that used to be in that location. Earlier, I forgot to dig through the system to show you the files that are actually on the computer after the reset. Now, mind you, there still will be a few that were on there and created while making this video, but here we go. So we have C drive. And remember, I had a big data backup folder there, that's gone. And then most user files are under the users folder. So we'll double click that, and any users on the computer would be listed here. So it would be this one right here, user. And then typically it's desktop, which should only show the files that are on the screen now, which are not my old files. The ones that don't appear are actually in the public folder under desktop. And then let's check out documents is empty. Downloads, these are things I used to make the video, so they're not old files. And music, empty. Pictures, just the standard Windows two folders there. And videos, again, I'm making this video, so these are related to what I just created in the last day or two. So nowhere else do I see data related to my old system before the secure erase procedure. So now let's run a little program called HXD to figure out what's in that free space and what Windows did when it secure erased it. So I'll right click and run as administrator on the 64-bit one, and it comes up. We click on the little drive icon here, select C drive, which is 465 gigs, so that's quite large. And then you get this screen. So these are the hexadecimal addresses of the sectors and clusters on the drive. And then you can see every now and again, you'll see something that you can understand, and there's some text. And this is looking at the raw data that's on the drive. And you know, if you scroll around a little bit, all the files that are currently live and active after the secure erase will have data, as you can see. But what I want to do is go to like a part in the middle of this drive to see what did Windows put in there. So if I scroll even more, it looks like just randomly generated characters. I don't see any words that I recognize. So my thought was that Windows Secure Erase most likely generates random data to overwrite the drive with during the process. So let's scroll down way down again. Yeah, and it just looks random. We're in the later part of the drive, so chances are this is just blank space that's been overwritten with garbage characters, so nobody can get anything useful out of it. So if I go back up to the top, you'll start to see things that you might recognize in words and things that actually are part of the active Windows system, but it's good to know that down below is just random garbage, and all the stuff you would have had on your drive before has been overwritten, and none of the utilities can get it back. So that's really good news. I feel great finally knowing this answer. If somebody has a way to contradict what I showed in this video, I want to know, and everybody else would want to know. But as far as I can tell from my own experiment here, once you secure erase that drive with the Windows erase procedure, you're good to go, and there's really no easy way that I can even think of that would get that data back. So that's great news. If you thought this was interesting, please subscribe to my channel and give the video a like. I'll try to keep making more tech videos in the future. Thank you so much for your support, and have an awesome day. Take care.